to magnify your names. We sing. Yes, he does.
sharing the next couple of hours with us. And we believe the Lord's going to speak to hearts and move upon hearts. Well, we want to thank everyone in the sanctuary and everyone watching for the help that you gave us this week on the Bay Share-a-thon. I just cannot express how grateful we are and how thankful we are for all that you have done. But I want to remind this that the Share-a-thon, our part ended when we left Saturday morning about 1:15. But the Share-a-thon itself, as far as the support for the network, it goes on to the end of the month. And I say that for this reason. There's always individuals that want to support, want to give, but during the week of Share-a-thon, they're not able to. But I just want to remind you that after Share-a-thon is over, next week, the week after, all the way into the last day of the month, you can help us with the May TV expenses of SBN. And if you call in a gift or you send it in, whatever the case, make sure you specify May Share-a-thon so that we can credit it appropriately. June the 10th through the 14th, we're having our next summer intensive class with Dr. Dave Watts. He's going to be teaching on the subject, how to study the Bible. And then on July 8th through 12th, Dr. Jimmy Dupree is going to be ministering on the subject, Intro to Christian Ministry. And these classes offered by JSBC are open to everyone. And we would encourage if you're a pastor, associate pastor, worker, or just a believer, if you're able to come down and be with us on these dates, I guarantee you, you're going to leave here more knowledgeable than when you came. For more information, you can go to jsbc.edu, jsbc.edu. Family Worship Center ladies are having a ladies' brunch on Saturday, June the 1st from 11 to 1. And second floor of the cafeteria, the A.N. Trotter building directly behind me. It's free. It's open to all of our ladies ages 12 and up. But you do need to sign up. And you can do so in the lobby at the Pastoral Care Station. And so tonight at 6 o'clock, we'll remind everyone to be back with us. And Pastor Mike Muzzerall will be ministering for us tonight at 6 o'clock. This morning as well, we're going to be praying for the needs of the people at the end of the service. It goes along with what I'm ministering this morning, and you'll understand. So if you have a need, I want you to store your faith up. Store your faith up for when we come around at the end of the service. This morning, from 22 states and 4 countries, we want to welcome 59 brand new Family Worship Center Media Church members. From Alabama, Ashley, Audrey, Cassidy, Chad, Darwin. Arizona, Mary, California, Eunice, Holly, Madeline. Florida, Donna, Hope, Luke, Marco, Nancy, Ronald. Georgia, Betty, Hawaii, Joanne. Illinois, Arthur, John, Tim. Kentucky, Bonnie, Carolyn, Jewel, Lisa, Terry. Maryland, Felicia, Shannon, Shirley, Minnesota, Anita, Missouri, Dee, Kenneth, and Blei, North Carolina, Stephen, New Jersey, Gail, Jennifer, New York, Nancy, Stanley, Vanessa, Ohio, Danette, Marianne, Robin, Oklahoma, Norris, Pennsylvania, Virginia, South Carolina, Don, Paula, Tennessee, Judy, Namon, Randy, Teresa, Texas, Andrew, Patricia, Virginia, Carrie, Wisconsin, Helen, Brown, Australia, Gary, Canada, John, Mildred, Norway, Paul Regard, and United Kingdom, Caitlin. Family Worship Center, would you stand this morning, look at this camera on my left, and let's welcome all of our brand new Family Worship Center Media Church members. We are just honored that you have chosen to come aboard with us, and we pray that Family Worship Center, through the teaching, the preaching, the music, will be a blessing into your heart and into your life. Family Worship Center, Resurrection Choir, and singers. Thank you.
Thank you.
No.
No. Oh, Pastor Donnie.
Yes, we do. More time.
Thank you.
listen to this right after that.
Yes, he is.
Yeah.
You feel the opposite, don't we, Lord? Yeah.
Man, you feeling good too.
It's become.
Until 2 weeks from now, he's
delivers.
Message of the cross. Egypt, as you said in this great book, is a kingdom of the world system. And believe me, the system of this world, the spirit of this world, is an enmity with the child of God.
Yeah.
Everything that this world combats against us. I was taken aback just a couple of days ago. I was looking at my dad's family.
Yeah, like when you say Jezebel.
Sure.
Right. It's funny.
Speaking at Oxford University, they have the Oxford debates, the Oxford Union, and at certain times of the year, many years of politics, whatever the case was, they speak on the subject. And I was reading her remarks. She really summed up what the world thinks of Christians. She said that it's a shame when too many of our citizens are hung up on God, gays, and guns.
Sad.
And she said they've just got to get their thinking straight.
No, not for long. Right.
You need to get your thinking
right. Here we are. It's foolish.
If we're hung up, what better thing to be hung up?
Right. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus Christ, the Son of God. This world, Egypt, is an enmity at war against us. And this is where God, though, brought the children of Israel from a little, small group, the sons and the wives of John. Until now, by the time that we get to the text, from what started out from a handful of people that came into the land because of a famine that God allowed to come, there's now 2 to 3 million Israelites. And we see in all of this that God is working to bring forth. Listen, nothing in this world is coincidence. God has a hand in everything.
Mm-hmm.
Understand that God has a hand. And it was hard to see, but in this heathen pagan nation, God was forming a people that would bring forth and give to the world the Word of God and give to the world the Savior of the world. And that's why we're pro-Israel.
Yeah.
That's why we stand with Israel. Not meaning that everything they do is right, because it's not. They are in rebellion. They are away from God. They are estranged from God. But they're coming back. They're coming back. They're coming back. And so as a child of God, we understand it. But in this strange land, God was forming the people. And in this strange land that we live in today, God is forming a people. He's formed us. He has chosen us. He has redeemed us. He has saved us by His precious blood. And we're in this world to be the light of the world and the salt of the earth. We're here to be a city set on a hill whose light will not be dim. And in this plan, God had to have a voice. He had to have a man. Israel was not going anywhere until Moses came along to the scene. And that's very important, because God, I don't care what dispensation you're living in, when you study the Word of God, God You gotta see. see this. I have no doubt that when God revealed himself to Moses on the backside of the desert, I mean, from the palace, the steps of Pharaoh, a general in the armies of Egypt,
done. Thank you.
Yeah. came to Baton Rouge and pioneered the second Assembly of God Church in the state. And when he made that announcement, that's when Dad felt the Lord say, he was working there the week and preaching on the weekends. And the Lord said, Coach John, take your son out of school. And traveling church to church, pulling a Utah truck, sleeping in church basements, sleeping in Sunday school rooms, sleeping in hallways of churches, and I kid you, when I take you, being stuck in people's homes. I love you, but I ain't seen it. I don't care if you got 75 rooms in your house. I ain't staying there. Back wherever I am. I'll stay at the 99 Motel before I go stay with you. No offense, but I've been there.
I'd rather stay at a hotel.
said you're a fool. Everybody said you're dumb broke. Not when God is designing a plan.
Right.
Not when Jesus Christ, the master architect, is drawing those plans. Oh, his plans are big plans. And then that plan goes forward. Start living this model.
Yeah.
Not a stick. Not a stud. God's
Broken the master. But yeah, we got together, this ain't good.
Thank you.
which cannot be touched with the finger of man, but was at all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Whatever we're suffering, it is already suffering in our place.
That's a good one.
Thank you. is four times. They are time one slack. Here is my question about the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit of Genesis Revelation. How the Holy Spirit works. And then, church, read the book of Acts and get ready. All four of these books are a very special offer for 60 hours. That's 50% off the regular price. Now, that's not all. As a very special bonus gift, you can receive Dan's music CD entitled There Is a River, subtitled Songs About shall surely die. And you give them not warning, nor speak to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life. The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at your hand. Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 18. The Lord, in effect, has made every single preacher of the gospel a watchman. We are to watch for evil sinners. We are to watch for false doctrine, especially false doctrine.
with us July 24th through the 28th here at Jimmy Square Ministries for International Youth Conference 2024.
Every believer needs to read this book called Sanctification. It'll help you to understand one of the greatest doctrines in the entirety of the Word of God. Most of Paul's teaching was in the realm of sanctification. That is not known by many, but it is a fact. Because it tells the believer how to live for God. Let me say that again. It tells the believer how to live for God. And for each of you can give $30 to get this book. We also want to give you as a bonus, I think, one of the best CDs I've ever made called Change My Heart, Oh God, Make It Ever New. And I'll promise you this, you won't play it one time and throw it aside. You'll play it over and over and over again. Now, take advantage of this offer. You need this book called Sanctification.
Thank you.
Mark it over nearly 200 pages. It'll bless your heart, that I promise.
Hello, this is Dr. Smiley. I want to invite everyone in the living South Dakota area to come and be with me June the 7th through the 9th. I'm going to be in Lemon at New Hope Worship Center. Friday night at 7 o'clock, Saturday night at 6 o'clock, and Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. Once again, that's June the 7th through the 9th, New Hope Worship Center, Lemon, South Dakota.
New Hope Worship.
We swept by, picked up here, there, but for now, you can go. See, are you sure? I haven't read these magazines. It's likely I won't, so you go too. So the next month's coming. Well, that month here, but you know, if you get magazine. See, you get.
Thank you. done so much for me. I cannot tell it all. Come on, just worship him for a moment. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I feel that tonight. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he is a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you've got chains, he's a chain breaker. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise God. Glory. You may be seated. My Lord, I feel that. I hear those chains falling. I hear those chains falling. Because there's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus. There's still power in the name of Jesus. I don't care what the world says. There's still power in the name of Jesus. There's still power in the name of Jesus. He's able to heal the sick. He's able to raise the dead. There's still power in the name of Jesus. One more time.
Well, if that's pure evil, I don't tell you, but you know, you can let here, huh? Pure evil. Yes, yes, yes.
Crucified,
moving forward toward the gospel, experience deliverance.
Not evil, you know that. But evil, wicked. Infidels are not the best any longer. It's finished. I'm gonna break in. Thank you.